it's a man or it's a woman, whether it's a woman leader or a person who is a part of a larger group. I was fortunate enough to start my career working under an amazing woman leader who had encouraged me, who had supported me and also everybody else along with me to bring their best to work and to do their best every day. Are there no challenges? No, I know that there are challenges, but it all depends on individuals, on how you are going to show up, how you are going to add value, and how you are going to put your voice on the table. So the seat at the corner table is not going to happen unless you push for it. I don't think this is something typical to the communication industry. I think it is a much larger discussion and a much larger issue to be addressed. And as you have asked me earlier in the course of our discussion, that there seems to be a lot more women in communication than men. And I think this is something that needs to be recognized at an industry level beyond communication. It is getting done in some levels and in some companies, and I think that's fantastic. Not just the pay gap, I think what needs to be addressed is the gap of opportunity and growth. I mean, are we giving women not just equal pay, but are we giving women equal opportunity to do what they are good at? And are we training them? Are we upskilling them? Are we supporting them at the time when they need to take a break from their work? So I think it's a much larger discussion and it's a much wider discussion which goes beyond the communication industry. I think men and women have equal responsibility to support each other in making each other's life professionally and personally successful. I have been extremely blessed, I would say, to have my husband in my life, who has been supporting me in all my decisions. I have an amazing son who has been exactly the same, supporting me, being independent, taking charge of his life. So overall, I think it has worked out well for me, but I know it's not necessarily so simple. But I think it is just something that we both have to consciously work at. I mean, when I say both, I'm talking about both men and women, and only then we will have the right kind of balance. Well, I think this is a very important time in our lives as communicators and as human beings. We are going through a very difficult and a very unusual time. My message to everybody will be, look out for each other, have each other's back. While maintaining social distancing, ensure that you are connected, ensure that you understand each other, you help each other out in every way possible, and work together, give each other the space you need, give each other the support you need, and at the same time, understand the context in which you are operating, and currently it's a very different one. So I started my career in Calcutta. I was a journalist who overnight pretty much moved into communications and public relations. Initial days were all about learning new things, all about allowing yourself to unlearn what you had learned as a journalist. So I would really put it across in two, three things. First, learning. Second, unlearning. Third is to create very strong relationships within the organization, so that I was able to deliver on the goal that I had set out to. I think the culture of an organization is all about bringing the best of yourself to your work every day. So I think it's all about equality, it is all about inclusiveness, and that has gender as one of its components. And in my organization, we consciously drive equality and inclusiveness across all different kinds of stakeholder groups. Well, I would agree and disagree with it, because when I started, I think a lot more women were in the communication industry, but I have seen over the years a lot of men have joined the industry, and that's fantastic because we needed this diversity, and I think that makes our industry unique and richer.